Hey there, it's Jang from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at an old Lego town set from 1983. This is just called Tractor Trailer. Simple as that. It came with 96 pieces. I love how they made kind of the default for a tractor trailer rig, kind of an 18-wheel style rig, to have the Lego brand. You know, it's kind of like saying, well, if you just have just a plain truck going down the street in the world of Lego, well, it's going to be a Lego truck and it's going to be delivering Lego goodies. This one right here, unfortunately, I did get it used. I didn't get it new in box because it's really hard to find new in box. And it is missing a sticker. It's supposed to have a Lego logo right there in the center of the rooftop spoiler. It would have been one that looked just like this and been just a little bit smaller, would have gone across both of those tile pieces. You can see that this is a four stud wide build, which was the standard back then and for quite the longest time. And gosh, it looks good proportion wise. I mean, just, you know, it's such a small size, but they made it work out just so well. In order to do that, they did have to use a number of specialized pieces. You know, back in the early 80s, people tend to think of Lego being all about just building things with bricks and blocks and such, but it wasn't like that at all. You've got these door pieces, which are essential to allowing a minifigure's arms, because a minifigure is wider than two studs, to fit inside of there. You've also got this folding roof and rear window kind of section, which acts like a panel in that it's got an opening, kind of a hollowed out space all throughout here, which is also very important for the minifig, for the back of the headgear, for the hair piece or the hat to fit in there. This piece up here also has extra headroom. I don't think it needed it in this case, but in some of them they did need that extra space with no studs and no stud receptacles on the bottom in order to actually fit a guy in there. This is really nice. There are, you know, different things that you can do with this. You can open the things up, close things. You can move this up. Not that you would ever want to do that, but it's just an additional thing that younger kids especially would be able to appreciate, I think. You've got your twin smokestacks back here. That's very nicely done for the scale. Also have fuel tanks is what's represented down here. Very well done also. The cool surprise, the thing that I wasn't expecting to see with this, is that the entire cab is able to tilt. It's a tilt cab design. And this is just the way that these vehicles are actually designed in real life. That's how you would get access to the engine. Of course, you don't have any engine detail here. There's not enough space to build up anything for that, but I appreciate that it can do this at all. It does have a hinge. It's got a turntable right down in here, and that's actually supposed to be where you separate this thing, separating the tractor from the trailer. It's four studs, so it is going to really hold on to there. That's really what you get just for the tractor section itself, you know. And they did use a printed piece here on the front. Oh, look at the little guy going around. They used the single printed piece on the front, not a sticker there, to get that kind of grill design. Just a short little thing, but again, the proportions are just right with this. And then with your trailer here, it does have the stand that comes down, and that's kind of a little funny. Kind of stands up a little bit too much. I think they could have used I actually don't know if they had stud pieces back then. I think maybe they only had the square ones, but one by one round, just a couple of those would have worked out better, you know, round plates rather than cylinders if they had them. But it kind of works. A lot of the shorter trailers would have been kind of angled up a little bit like that. Got the same size wheels and tires all the way around. This is pretty nice and flush back here with the windows in the back. Looks like this might be just a little bit off. Old pieces, you know, sometimes they don't assemble together just right. You gotta really push them together. And these open up. Very nice. They used a window frame back here, just in the same color as everything else. So you've got shutters, and you could put additional actual glass inside of there if you had the pieces. But that just gives you plenty of room to put stuff in there. They did not include any cargo with this set, so you have to make up your own. Just use bricks. It's a great thing about transporting cargo, and one of the reasons that I personally felt that the cargo-based sets in the 80s and such were really great, because, you know, you always had some extra pieces, and even if you didn't have official Lego pieces, you could still just use anything that you had around the house that was small enough, and you could transport it around. So I think this right here is a little bit not quite ideal for a connection point, but just a nice truck overall. And then here you've got your guy, your driver with what became a very common just worker uniform. No print on the back of this. He's got the police style hat, but in red here, just keeping it from looking like police. You know, that's all there is to it. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. And wow, this guy's in really great shape for his age, isn't he? So this was a really nice little set that would have looked just great in any Lego city of any size. So I really like this one. Happy to have gotten my hands on it. I'm looking forward to checking out the newer versions of Lego trucks that were made since then. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this quick look at this small little set, and I hope that you'll come back for more because more videos are always on the way. And be sure to follow the blog at jangbrickss.com to make sure that you see everything that I'm up to that's Lego related. Talk to you soon.